Making your submission. Anonymous file submission points are made available from within Yorkshare VLE's site content areas and will only accept files of less than 30 megabytes in size. To submit your work, make sure it is fully saved and in a file format your department and the submission point will accept. Locate the correct submission point for your file and then click on the Submit Anonymous Assignment link that appears below the title of the submission point or below the accepted file types list. When the submission form is displayed, click the button next to File to submit. This may say Choose File or Browse, depending on which browser you are using. Then, in the ensuing standard file dialog, find and open the file you wish to submit. Once selected for submission, you will see the name of the file you have just chosen appear next to the button. Check that you have attached the correct file and then read the details in the anonymity and declaration sections of the form. You must tick the boxes in these two sections of the form to indicate that you understand and confirm them before you can submit your work. You tick the box by clicking in it. Be sure to read section 4 of the form regarding email confirmation of your submission before completing submission of your work by clicking the submit button. Once submitted successfully, you will see a receipt screen summarizing the details of your submission. It is very strongly advised you immediately check that you submitted the file that you intended to submit and also that it has integrity directly post-submission by downloading your work using the provided link on the receipt screen. Download the file from the link. Ensure that this downloaded file opens as expected and that it is the version of your work that you intended to submit. You will also receive an email version of the receipt sent to your university email address. This email will confirm the details of your submission, including your unique submission ID and the name of the file you submitted, as well as the date and timestamp the file was received. This is proof of your submission and can be used to find your submission in the unlikely event of a problem. The email version of the receipt doesn't provide you with a link to the file you submitted. You can still check your submission at any time, however, by re-entering the submission point itself. A list of all the submissions you have made thus far to that submission point, along with links to download them, will appear at the top of the submission form, starting with the most recent submission at the top of the list. Your most recent submission before the deadline is the one that will be marked. Always read all assessment and submission instructions provided by your staff and your department. Such information will typically include notes on what to do in an emergency or if you need to claim an exceptional or mitigating circumstance, for example. Always give yourself sufficient time to make your submission electronically. It is advised that you start a submission at least a half hour before the deadline. Always check the file you have submitted immediately after submitting it. Download the file from the receipt screen. Make sure this downloaded file opens as expected and check that it is the version of your work that you intended to submit. Always keep the submission receipt that is emailed to you. When attempting your submission, carefully read any on-screen messages that you receive if your submission doesn't appear to immediately submit or can't be submitted. These on-screen messages will tell you why your file hasn't met the submission criteria or will indicate something you may need to be aware of about the file you are attempting to submit.